Today, we're reviewing a software called Coconote. Yes, Coconote, not Cocomelon. It is an app that you can use for as a student or for meetings or for in-person AI note-taking. We're going to see whether it is worth it or whether it is just another AI note-taker app that you should just ignore. So I have installed it on iOS. It's available on Android and does have a web app. I'll explain the web app in a bit and give you my general opinion, the pros and cons and things like that. If you're looking for Coconote, you can find it linked below. And if you're looking for any more AI tools, go over to toolfinder.co. You'll find absolutely loads there. So I downloaded Coconote for iOS. Now, to be honest, my opinions were, first looking at it, that it's got a 4.9 on the App Store rating. So that's a really good news that it's got that many people saying that it's a positive app. It's also apparently got 1 million students and individuals using the app. So again, so another good bit of credibility. However, when you go in the app, you get set up, you put in all your details and all that, and you're hit with a paywall. Now, the paywall is fairly aggressive. The pricing is something like £129 for a year, which works out, I believe, at about £12 to £13 per month. And that is the cheapest plan that I see currently available. Now, that is quite expensive for a note taker. So we've got to see what it actually does to warrant that sort of pricing. So I created my first note. I recorded something in the background, and what it did is it went away and transcribed it for me, much like other applications like Otter, Granola, and Fellow. They're all popular AI meeting tools, but this one is good because it has a local one, and it's also designed for other features like flashcards and quizzes, which we'll come to later. Now, it created the note fairly well. As you can see on screen, it pretty much gave a summary and breakdown like you would typically see. Now, during the recording, you can also flag bookmarks. You can also write your own notes, which are helpful, but they appear at the bottom. And you can also edit your note, translate it, and download the initial recording. Now, something that you may not see, but you can actually chat with the note, which means you can use the information stored to break down something that you learnt in the lecture. Now, of course, you could use this for lectures or for a meeting in person, maybe going down the road, but you always have to make sure you have the permission of the other person. Now, what makes this application slightly different is it has a few features that's designed more for students. There's this feature called flashcards, which allows you to turn all of the things that were mentioned or the key points into flashcards, and you can flip them. And what's nice is if you don't get them right or wrong, you can set active recall up, which is a technique that students use to help learn and remember things. So it helps to loop that back, which is nice. So again, basic, but good. That's a good feature. Many people will like that if you're a student. The other thing that you get is a quiz. Again, helpful and practical. And they haven't necessarily gone for the most attractive look, but at the same time, it just works well. So at the same time, that's something that people will like. Now, this application is quite heavy on getting notifications. It probably works better with it. And at the same time, the application does base on the transcript. So it's obviously all dependent on the quality of the transcript itself. So there are two other features. You can also create a video and a podcast. It's quite weird. The video is almost like a Minecrafty type video, probably better for students and something you would probably be able to create on something like Opus Clip, which is a generation platform. It's nothing really amazing, but again, if you're somebody that's visual, then you might like that. You can also create a podcast of it too. Now in the app, they also have something called study games. Now I played with this and some of them were relevant. Like there's a matchup game, but the other ones were completely irrelevant. Like it's just like they threw these games in with a vibe coding app and basically some of them were relevant or not. I mean, don't get me wrong, they're not the worst games, but neither are they the best games. It's something that it sort of just feels like just thrown in for the bonus, if that makes sense. Now, in terms of the actual transcription, you can speed it up, you can actually replay it, and you can see the full transcription of what was said during the session. You can also share that and the note summary with other people. You can also export the flashcards to Anki if you currently use that. So apart from that, there is a web app, and the web app pretty much does the same, but you can upload YouTube videos. You can do that on the mobile version. And you can upload the YouTube videos and it helps summarize what that is in that video, which again is really helpful. You can also upload PDFs and text, as well as audio if you recorded it locally. Now, there is a limit on the free plan. I'll include the details below because I haven't yet found what the differentiation is between the free plan and the paid plan. But do I think it's worth it for checking out? The answer is no. This application is uniquely designed. I don't see many other apps doing the flashcard element and the quiz element, but the application has not so nice design. It's really put together in a very strange way where it just feels like some features are just thrown in. And the application is probably better suited at a price point that is much lower. If this app was something like $3 to $4 or £4 per month, I would say this is probably actually a good app. But at the current price point, I don't know whether they offer some more aggressive deals as you get into it, is too expensive and it is too pricey. So again, I think that overall as a package, although despite the good App Store rating, and the amount of users using it, I believe that a lot of people do download this, but they may not actually use this as a paid product. I don't think it's as valuable. There are other tools I do think are probably better value in terms of the package. There's an app called Recall AI, which does the exact same of the stuff. It does the quiz and the chatting with the notes, and it does it at a lot lower price point. I believe $8 or $7 per month. And the reason is a free plan as well with that too. There's also an app called Remnote, which does student flashcards very, very well. And I believe the flashcards function is free to use. The AI flashcards function is, I think, part of their paid plan, but their paid plan, again, is reasonable for what you get as a package. So in my opinion, I think this app is not as good as what it looks like from the surface. But like all apps we review on Toolfinder, we'll continually review them, work out which one's best, and of course, they're bound to release updates in the meantime. Thank you so much for stopping by in this video. Again, if you're finding tools for being a student or general, then you can jump over to toolfinder.co. But you can find loads of alternatives over on the link in description. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.